we have discussed yesterday, the last time, have you seen the video yesterday? Not.
No.
You brought the mobile today.
The
same
thing. There is no charge. I forget to charge
my. The questions I gave you yesterday about the remainder theorem we have discussed, okay? What do you understand by the term remainder theorem? Means in a simple, talking about this, there is a some polynomial I'm writing right now. So there is a polynomial P of x. P of x, clear? P of x, 3x cubed plus x squared. Plus x, 4 is there. Is that clear? This is a polynomial of the degree 3. Clear? If we are dividing this polynomial by another polynomial, name of the polynomial is x plus 2. Clear? So do you know what is the process of division? Simply, everybody know the process of division. We also can divide it by x plus 1. So we need to divide it. This polynomial is to divide it by, to be divided by 1. X plus 1. 3x cubed and x squared plus x plus 4. The division of polynomial process, you have studied in the 8th class. The process of division I am telling you, x plus 1. So what is the coefficient of this division? X coefficient? 3. X coefficient is
1.
3 divided by 1? 3. What is the degree difference between them?
2.
So 2 is there, okay? And this is to be multiplied by 3, 1 is 3 and x square. 3, 1 is 3, x square, 3 x square. And degree 1, 2 and degree 1, here will be 3. And 3 times x square is 2. Okay? After the multiplication by this term to the divisor, what the polynomials or what the value comes, you just have to write the terms below the same degree. Below the same degree, this is carrying the degree 2. This is carrying the degree 2, right? Under the same degree terms should be written. Negative. Positive, negative cancels. Plus and minus. Minus. And the sign will come up greater. Okay? Operation will minus. Plus, minus, minus. And the sign will come greater. 3 minus 1 time. 3x times 3x square is 3x. 3 times x square. 1 times x square. 2 times x square. Plus x plus 4. Is that clear? Again the division will go on there. Minus 2 divided by 1. What will you have between? Minus 2. What is the degree difference?
1.
The degree difference 1. 1 is to be written. Again multiply. Minus 2x square. Minus 2, 1 is 2. 2x. And further it's positive or it's positive. X cancels. Clear? 1 times x, 2 times x. How many times x is there? 3 times. So it's 4. Is that clear? Again, what is coefficient?
3.
X coefficient?
1.
3 divided by 1 is what? 3. What is the degree difference? Nothing. Right now?
Yes.
Nothing. So we will not write down the term of x. 3 1 is 3x. And what is coming here? 3 1 is 3. And it's minus and plus. Negative. Let's cancel here. 4 minus 3?
1.
Can you divide further? No. What is the degree of this coming?
1.
No. 0. Constant polynomial is occurring here. A constant polynomial is with the degree 0. Its degree is
1.
Since the degree of the remaining terms is less than the degree of divisor, now we conclude that remainder approaches. Is that okay? How can you know that remainder comes? If the terms remaining here having the degree less than the degree of this, then we conclude that this is a remainder. Okay? Is that right? So division we have done here. So what the remainder is coming here? What the remainder coming here?
One
remainder. We are doing another activity. Is that clear? What is that? Since x plus 1 divides x plus 1 divides px. X plus 1 divides px. Okay? Therefore, we are just finding p of minus 1. The value of polynomial we are finding p of minus 1 means by changing the sign of that. Clear? P of minus 1. If here is written x minus 1, then we will find out P of plus 1. If here is written x minus 2, then we will find the value of P of 2. Clear? P of of months, this is the polynomial, okay? 3 minus 1 to the power 3, again minus 1 to the power 2, and here is minus 1 and here is plus 1, okay? Right now, minus 3 times together, it will give you what? Minus 1. Minus 1 square means what? 1. And minus 1 plus 4. Further is to be 3, 1 is 3, minus 3. And plus minus cancels here. Four. So what is coming here? Minus 3 plus 4. 1 here. Okay? See that. This is what coming here? 1. This is numerically equals to remainder. Is that clear? It means the remainder can be brought. It's very simple. This thing yesterday I told you, right? If any polynomial divides the other polynomial and we obtain the value of polynomial by substituting its constant term in place of x, then a value is to be obtained there. This value numerically equals to its remainder. Is that clear? So what the statement will be? The statement will be, if the statement is there, if x plus a divide p of x, any degree, okay? Can you see this on the screen? P of a, if x plus a divides p of x, then implies that p of a is equal to, what is this p of a is equal to?
P.
No.
Remainder.
It's a remainder. This statement is called the remainder theorem. This was the topic of yesterday, right? And if suppose that the other polynomial is also being given here, just like that, please see on the screen a question on the study material, please. X plus 1. Question number, page number 7, I'm talking about page 7. Question number 20, you will see. Question number 20. See any of this? Question number 20. By remainder theorem, find the remainder when px is divided by
gx.
Is that clear? And also, there, some questionnaires are here. Question number 21 is also here. Check whether px is multiple of gx. The meaning of multiple means in the table of gx, px will occur. It means simply we can speak here. Question number 21, page 7. Question 20, 21, 19, 18, they all are of the same. Clear? Is that clear? And the statement of the remainder theorem, you may see in the beginning of the chapter, page number 1 of the same. Okay? Page number 1 of the same. And bullet number 7, you may see. Zeros of polynomial, topic. Remainder theorem. Found your remainder theorem?
Yes,
if px be a polynomial of degree n, px be a polynomial of degree n, okay, is divided by, n is divided by x plus a, then remainder is equal to p of minus a. This is a method we can say to find out the remainder. Is that it? See guys, another topic related with this, if 0 will occur here, if 0 will occur, then what do we conclude? As the process of division, if suppose that there is, here we just like that 9. 9 is to be divided by 2. So what comes here? 2 4s are 8 and it's what? 1 is left here. Okay? The remainder is coming here. Then we conclude 2, it does not go completely in 9. We can speak here 2 is not a factor of 9. Clear? In the same manner, if this is the px polynomial here, right now, and this is being divided by this polynomial. Okay? The name of the polynomial is gx. Here, the px polynomial is being divided by gx polynomial, the process goes on continuing, and here our remainder comes here, means non-zero value occurs here. Then what do we conclude? We can speak here x plus 1 is not a factor of 3x square plus x square plus x plus 4. Means this method, this remainder term can be used for the two ways. First, to find out the remainder, and second, to check whether it is the factor of or not, right? Simply. So another question is there. See the question number 19. What the question
Sir,
number 19? What?
Sir, there is x plus 1. If there will be x plus 1 plus 2. So
x plus 1 plus 2.
X minus 1 plus 2. So
wait a minute.
So which
wait
symbol
minute.
Which will take?
Yeah, this is. What please speak here?
X plus
1
minus 2.
Minus 2, this cannot be, this is not a proper polynomial. Means constant term two times you have used here. It will occur
take
once.
It like 2x.
2x, that's right here. 2x plus 1.
2x plus 1.
Yes, I told in the video. Do you remember or not?
Yes.
If 2x plus 1 is occurring, always when gx is, gx is I think here 2x plus 1. So then this first you have to take equals to 0. Is that clear? And the value of x, 2x is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to minus 1 upon 2. Then you have to find out p of minus 1 by 2. Is that clear? This is the actually, I told you the same thing as, because I know this, there is always doubt that occurs in the mind. So I told in the video lecture, right? No?
If there will be 2x plus 1 minus x,
2x,
so
wait a minute, 2
x,
x
plus 1
minus
x.
Minus x. This cannot be a proper polynomial. Why? Because the degree of x is the single degree of occurring two times here. First we will operate them. Obviously this is not a proper polynomial in mathematics. Okay? First we will operate them. 2 times x minus 1 times x. X plus 1. Okay? First we will simplify it. In mathematics always we give the situation simplified then to solve it.
माइनस
एंड प्लस हाउ इज दिस यू लेट मी गिव द एग्जांपल्स हियर यू नीड टू
लाइक 2x प्लस 1 माइनस x स्क्वायर
माइनस x स्क्वायर x स्क्वायर दिस इज कॉल्ड द डिविजंस बाय द क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल इज दैट क्लियर इट मींस यू आर सेइंग दैट माइनस x square plus 2x and plus 1. This is a quadratic polynomial. Then what you will take here? Then you will solve, again you will take it equal to 0 and you will factorize it. You will factorize it. This is the next topic of the chapter here. Factorizing the quadratic polynomial. Is that clear? And then you will use it. Okay? And now here in the course here, division by linear polynomial is only there. Okay? And later I will take you the factorization. So come on, you got this completely?
Yes.
The remainder theorem. So I'm repeating this. What is the remainder theorem? If Px be a polynomial of any degree and it is divided by x plus a, x minus a, x plus a, then what will be its remainder? P of minus a will be its remainder. So the sum question based on these. Yes. Look at question number 12. Yesterday we have discussed. Divide the polynomial 3x square, 3x to the power 4 minus 4x cube minus 3x minus 1 by x minus 1. Okay? So, can you find the remainder? Now, need to divide it here. Directly it's saying it to divide. So, do you know the division process? Now, second question number 13. Find the remainder obtained on dividing this. How can we obtain the remainder? Is it saying to find out the remainder by division method? No. He's saying to find only remainder. So, we can find the remainder by remainder theorem. Okay, please proceed it ahead and define very immediately. Please start writing this. Keep your notebook open. Find the remainder obtained on dividing x cube plus 1, x plus 1. Solution number 12. 13. You always have to write first what is given here. Px is x square, x cube plus 1. And x plus 1. Px is x cube plus 1 and gx is what here? X plus 1. You can give gx the divisor, okay? Always. Gx is equal to.
So you are talking about 13 number question.
13 number question, I said. X cube plus 1 and what the next is? X plus 1 is also there. Listen again. The divisor is to be supposed as gx and dividend is to be supposed as
yes.
Dividend means the polynomial with the term which is being divided and the gx divisor that is dividing. Okay. Fine.
Page number
7. A7 question number 13. Px is the polynomial x cubed plus 1 and gx is x plus 1. How? Is number 2, sorry, is this right? Is it same thing? Yeah. Page number 2 is this. Sorry, it's page number 2 here.
Yes.
What did I say?
Page number 2.
Page number 2. This is the page number of my iPad 7. On this, again, P of, since Px is divided by, Px is divided by x plus 1, okay, therefore, remainder. Remainder Rx is equal to, how can you find out the remainder Rx? P of minus 1. Now we have written this. We have written this by
remainder
theorem. Is that clear? This is remainder theorem. By remainder theorem. So, what is 2? Place up there. This is the Px polynomial. Minus 1 whole to the power 3 plus 1. Minus 1, 3 times will occur. Minus, minus, minus,
minus.
Is that clear? What does this conclude here?
Zero.
0 is coming here. What does this mean? 0 is the remainder is there. The second conclusion we can draw, Gx will completely divide x plus 1. If we will divide it, then it will go completely in the x cube plus 1. So the remainder theorem can be used for the two purposes. First is to know whether any factor polynomial is a multiple of the other, or the other is the factor of first one, or the what remainder will come. Okay. See that question number 14 yesterday I gave you. Find the remainder when this is divided by this. Can you find this or not? The same. These questions yesterday we have discussed. Okay. Right now, and this is the time that I am repeating this. From next day I will not repeat. You will see our note. Right. Question number 15. Check whether the polynomial qt, 4t square, it's not a 4t, and I also explained here, 4t square and 4t cube there. I also corrected in the video. Do you remember this one? Right? It's a 4t cube. 4t cube minus plus 4t square minus t minus 1 is multiple of 2t plus 1. Is that it? When this situations occurred, then I explained in this 2t plus 1. So here 2t plus 1. Since 2t plus 1 divides Px. Okay? Therefore, 2t plus 1 divides Px. What is Px? There is a remainder. Okay? Then, what is remainder here? Then, remainder is equal to P of what? How will you bring P of? So same thing I told you this, 2t plus 1 is to be equal to 0. So it's what here, 2t is equal to minus 1 and t is equal to minus 1 by 2. This is to be taken, right now? So we need to find out minus 1 by 2. Clear? Now proceed. This is the rough work you can do, or also you can take this as a part of solution. Clear? Now what the next? P of minus half? P of minus half? What is P, please tell me? 40
cube.
40 cube. 40 cube.
4T
of half cube plus
4T square
minus T.
Minus 1.
There is. Okay. Now proceed it. 4 into minus 3 times letter. Minus.
Minus 1.
And 1 for 2, 3 times letter. What? 8. Minus minus plus 2 times and 1 square 1, 2 square 4. Minus minus plus x 1 by 2 minus. All are numerical, okay? So further can be, it cancels here 1 and 2. What's your 1 by?
2.
4
cancels.
It's plus 1. And it's plus half.
Plus
and plus minus 1. So plus 1 plus 1 cancel. Plus half minus half cancels. What's coming it is?
0.
The remainder coming 0. What do we conclude?
That pH.
So 2t plus 1 completely divided is a multiple of that pH. Okay? This is the conclusion, right? So don't you think this is long and lengthy complex process of the divisions, predicting whether any zeros and factors and the finding remainder? This is another method, that remainder theorem. You will call the remainder theorem, right? So to solve some questions by yourself. Question number 15, as we have solved. Question number 16, find a remainder when this is divided by these. How many questions are there altogether? 5 questions are there. Means the polynomial Px, what is Px is given here? Px is given x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. First you need to find out P of y minus 1 plus 1.
What?
X
plus 1.
P of minus 1. We will find out
half.
P of minus 1. Then second we will find out
P of half.
P of plus half. Okay.
P of half.
Next.
P of pi.
Pi the symbol. What is the value of pi?
22
pi. The students generally ask me whether sir pi values to be put here this and pi values to be calculated here 22 by 7. So in the place of that you will put the values and automatically will get solution. Right now I'm telling this.
So you also pi will not convert into minus.
Minus pi you will take here. So please start finding this. You also. I'm also finding this. You want this? To solve. What is px? Please speak with.
px
cube. X cube plus 3.
Plus px square.
X
plus
cube plus 3x square
plus 3x plus
1. 3x plus 1. Or
x plus pi.
Please go right in this. Since x plus pi. Divide. Means this line is to be copy pasted, okay? Px divided by this, Px divided by this. Then remainder theorem by same procedure. Okay? Remainder Rx is equal to P of
minus 1.
What is minus 5? Please do calculate. Place of x, you have put what? Minus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 3
plus
5 3 5 x plus 5, so minus 5 is to be put here, right?
Yeah.
And plus 1, calculate minus. minus pi 3 times millimeter minus minus 3 times 50 degrees 3 pi square minus 3 pi plus 1. And what next is, now here you will ask whether sir pi is to be put in the as value 20 as 22 by 7 or some other way. So I don't think you have to put here because it will not give the right value. Yes, this is your answer. 22 by 7 is not to be put here. And pi. Since you will write here, pi is a what we can speak here. Pi is rational 22 by 7. Now it will not cover terminating decimal, sorry, terminating decimal exponent. So further it cannot be solved here. So bus you just let it remain as it is. This is your remainder. The next question, 5 2 plus x. This you can solve or not? 5 plus 2x. Again, same. Go on writing this.
Is equal to 0 and
yes,
I have to take it.
Fourth question. Repeat what? Since px is divided by what next? 5 plus 2x. Okay. Therefore, what is remainder? Remainder. Rx is equal. How can you find it? P of what? You tell me, please. P of what?
5 plus 2x minus.
So what is that P of? P of means 5 plus 2x is equal to 0. 2x is equal to minus 5. And x is equal to minus 5 by 2. Is that clear? P of minus 5 by 2. Can you calculate this? Please proceed further. Taking too much time, so fast.
So we have to take the value of x equals
to exactly minus 5
by 2.
So minus 5 by 2 is we taken here 3 times and 3 minus 5 by 2
square
also
plus 3
plus 3 and
minus
5
by
2
plus 1
and plus 1 is there also. Okay, let's go on 3 times minus minus minus. 5 5s are 25. 25 5s are 125. And this will give you 8. And further, 3 into minus minus 2 times will give you positive plus. 5 5s are 25. Divided by 2 to the 4. And next also minus. 3 5s are 15 divided by 2 plus 1. Now carry on this next. Minus 125 for the next. And further, 3 5 sir, 75 by what? 4. And later also, minus 15 that is. And plus 1 also. Okay. Further, there are LCMs to be taken here because there are the numericals that can be calculated as. Okay. So, what you will have?
8.
It's 8, the LCM. I think, yes, 8 LCM. Minus 125. 8 goes in 8 goes by 4 2 times. Okay, 4 goes in 8 2 times. So 275 2s are 150. And again here 2 goes in 8 4 times. 50 goes are 60 plus 8 is here. And you know how the process of division this LCM done here? But you know, it's first try to divide the denominator by this. Okay, and what comes is to multiply with the numerator. Again, this 4 goes in 8, how many times? 2 times. And and 2 is to be multiplied here. And 2 goes in 8, 4 times. The 4 comes here to be multiplied by 50. Remember this? Now proceed it ahead. What will come? Minus 120, negative negative is to be minus minus plus.
Yes.
First is to be operated there, okay? And this to be operated here. So here will 158 plus 8. 125, 16, what is that? 185. And minus this is, okay, 8. And to be calculated this. Okay, proceed further. And what the answer is coming? Final answer. Then you have to show the next piece.
So which one we have to solve?
Question that. For the next question.
Find the remainder when x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a is divided. Sir, there is two variables
are there. Two variables. A and the other also.
Yeah, A and X.
A, B, C are not used as variables. I already have declared this. So A is a constant sum. Please read the question again. What the question exactly is saying?
Find the remainder when X cube minus AX square plus 6X minus A is divided by X minus.
See on the screen what the questioner is saying here. What is it saying? Check whether the polynomial 4t square is no 15, 16, 17.
17.
The question was 17. What is it saying? Find the remainder when x cube minus ax square plus x a minus a divided by x minus. This right here. Variable a, b, c are not used as a variable. They are used as a constant. So you have to follow the procedure, okay? Since x minus a divides this px, okay? Then the remainder is p of a. And put in the place of x a and to calculate. Please proceed that. Go on writing this, please. Write down what is p of.
Yeah, I didn't understand.
Did you understand the procedure and method? What we have to put in place of x? What we have to put in place of x?
P.
We have to put in place of x?
A.
A. And to be calculated is just like a cube, a to the power 3, a cube will come, a to the power 2, a square will come, and go ahead, you will obtain answer, please. Since p of x. Solution 7. P of x is x cube x square plus 6x minus a. And since x minus a divides px. answer? Of a to the power 3 in place of the a square, in place of x square, yeah. Plus 6 into a in the a also. This is 6 something else.
6.
6 it is, you may see on the screen. Is it a cube and a cube will also a square into a cube will there. Plus 6, 8, minus 8. Yeah? Have you done? Two. One
a
letter to begin.
A cube minus.
Is a cube minus.
A cube will part.
Will cancel.
Yes, cancel.
Right? No. 6 times A minus 1 time
A.
5. 5 times A. Can it be solved further?
No.
No. Stop this. And the situation not further to be solved. Very simplified there. This is answer. What is answer in mathematics? When the situation comes very easy, further not need to be solved. This is answer. Is that clear? What is answer in mathematics? Very simplified term. Is that clear? When you say the situation of your life is too difficult, when you don't understand what will happen to about to happen, or just coming the next moment, what will happen with you? Then you say the life is in trouble. When you understand what is about to happen, life is easy. The same the concept and philosophy of mathematics. Isn't it clear? When you say the problem is very difficult mathematical because you don't know the answer. Because the term is appearing very complex. Right now, you try to bring in simplified form. This is your solving activity. Right now, you make your effort to solve the question. And when the terms comes, it's a very easy term. This is answer. So what is answer? Simplified situation. Right now? Your assignment of the day, see on the screen what is that? Question number 19. X plus 2 is a factor of this. Check whether it is a factor. Factor means what? Same is to be done. Factor theorem is to be there. Okay. So, same process. Not you have to find the remainder. Remember, however, you have to do the same by the remainder method. Okay. So, question number 18. Check whether 7 plus 3x is a factor. So, what you will put in place of x? Minus 7 by 3. Okay, minus 7 by 3, and you will calculate. If 0 is coming, then it is a factor. So we can modify the statement here. Okay, please write a factor theorem. What will be the factor theorem? It's very simple here. If Px be a polynomial of degree, Px if be a polynomial of degree n.
What?
Px be a degree of, be a polynomial. Be a polynomial, or also you can write is a polynomial of degree n. Degree n. N divided by n is divided by x plus a. N is divided by x plus a. Divided by x plus 6 such that p of a is equal to 0. P of minus a is equal to 0. P of minus such that
p of minus a is
such that p of minus a is equal to 0. If 0 comes here, okay, then or implies that x plus a is a factor. Okay, x plus a is a factor of that. Is that clear? Right now, so your assignment of the left, question number 18, 19 and 20 minutes to be done. Is that clear, guys? Please take it. solve this,